so far, so good. It's very humid, very sticky,
yes.
But it's beautiful. We're really enjoying it. We got to explore a little bit today, and we had a lot of fun.
We went, I guess it was called the Arab District, and walked through all the shops there, and there's like the mausoleum there. It's really cool, and our manager, Adam, he got a little more adventurous than we did. We slept a little bit more than, but he's been around everywhere, so he told us about it. And there's a lot more to explore, though.
Yeah.
Won't let you fall.
I know your favorite player.
Yeah, that's it.
Serena Williams.
Yeah.
She loves
it. Yeah, like, I know. I'm so excited. Hopefully I get to meet her and give her a high five or something.
She looks amazing. Up to her. She checks her out on social media and is like, how do I get muscles like her?
Yeah, I know.
What do I have to do?
I can't even, I'm not good at tennis, I'll be honest. I'm only good at video games, like Mario tennis, you know, I'm good at that.
Yeah.
The thumbs and, you know, the Wii.
Well, your number one experience has to be Oprah hugging you on stage.
Yeah, definitely. On the first day of our tour, we weren't expecting to meet Oprah at all, but we were performing on stage and people started screaming really loud, and I was like, I don't know if they're screaming for us. I mean, we're not that good.
Not that cool.
I mean, we're not that cool yet. So then we turn around and Oprah walks on stage, and then she just gave us a big hug and was like, you guys sound great. And I was just freaking out. I didn't know what to do. My jaw was like to the floor. I was just like, ah. Another huge moment for us is our song that we actually wrote for our wedding. It's our wedding vows. It's called No Matter Where You Are. It is in a film called The Book of Life. So that was a big deal for us, just to see the characters. Zoe Saldana sings my part, and then Diego Luna sings Michael's part. So it's just really cool to see animation singing our song that we wrote for our wedding.
Performing live on Good Morning America, which is like the biggest morning television show in the US. Was the most nervous I've ever been in my entire life. If you can imagine, I mean, her and I, we've been filming iPhone videos on our couch. Yes. So when Good Morning America calls you up and says, Michael and Carissa, I want you to come on our show and perform live for 5 million plus people. I'm like, but we only do iPhone recordings on our couch. How are we supposed to do that in New York City in front of millions of people? So we did it, and there is no feeling like playing on live television. I mean, every mistake, there's no going back, you know? It's just what it is.
Yeah, you can't be like, hold on, can we do that
again?
Can we
do that again?
One more time. And then our top favorite moment in life is getting married. shooting No Matter Where You Are, our music video, was really exciting because it was our first music video ever under our label, Republic Records. So, you know, you have a huge production team, and it's just crazy arriving there and seeing a team of people working, you know, for this video and to make it all happen and make the magic happen.
Did the face paint
help? Yeah.
It took very long.
It did. There's a lot of stressful moments with the face paint because we were on a tight schedule and we wanted to film the video, so had no makeup, and then they were adding pieces, you know, so it was light makeup and then more, and same with her, so they were adding jewels in between shots, and it was, we had a tight time deadline, and the makeup artist is, you know, panicking, because she's like, we gotta finish, this takes time, this is my art, you can't rush it, and we were like, I totally understand, and the director was like, go, 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 we need this.
I couldn't even, like, wipe my eye.
And it was really hot, there was no air conditioning, so we started to sweat, and I wanted to be like, oh, but then I realized it would all wipe off. So we had these
that
little fans,
bad.
These like portable fans, and we were blowing them on her face, like, come on. Yeah. She was blowing me. There's a million other guys who would. We share very similar musical tastes. We both grew up listening to soul music, Michael Jackson, and Stevie Wonder, and Earth, Wind, and Fire, and a lot of cool bands like that. And as we grew up, we started listening to pop music. She loves Beyonce. I love John Mayer and Bruno Mars and people like that. So we pulled all of our influences together and meshed them into one sound. So it's been a very unique process. When we write, it's really a collaboration of our minds. You know? I think I'm a piano player, so I think a lot of jazz chords and different melodies, and she's not an instrumentalist, and that's actually great because she brings in melodies that I would never think of. That's a great question.
Yeah.
You can never run out of love songs because each person's individual love story is personal to them. So we live out things together that maybe no one else has lived out, you know, or maybe they have, but we just like to write what's currently happening in our lives. And people will relate to that because they've either gone through something similar, or maybe they haven't and they want that kind of love, or maybe they have a better love and they're looking at us like, haha, they're so young. But either way, you know, as long as we keep writing what we're living, it'll never run out.
For our vines, because it's only 6 seconds, we usually choose the most catchy part of a song, even do mashups sometimes, which is really crazy to fit like 6 or 5 different songs from one artist into 6 seconds. It's kind of hard to do, but we'll basically take like a word from each one.
By this time we know exactly what 6 seconds is, so yeah. A song will come on the radio and we'll be like, that was 6 seconds.
That's it right there, let's do that.
I will stay by you.
I would look at when we have a family and kids. I want to see what they look like.
So you stand tall.
If I had 6 seconds to hang out with anyone, it would be Michael Jackson. And I would say, how did you write the Thriller album? Tell me your secrets.
Teach me how to moonwalk.
Teach me how to moonwalk. That is a great question. If I had 6 seconds to broadcast to the entire world one message.
So I'll be counting.
Are you ready?
Ready, go.
Follow your heart, fall in love, and do everything with all of your energy.
6 seconds.